The Music of Chance, written by Paul Auster, is an absurdist novel that captivated readers upon its publication in 1990, garnering recognition as a finalist for the P.E.N. Faulkner Award for Fiction. This thought-provoking tale later made its way to the big screen in 1993. The story follows Jim Nashe, a dedicated firefighter hailing from Boston, Massachusetts. Devastated by his recent separation from his wife Therese and overwhelmed by the prospect of raising their daughter Juliet alone, Jim relinquishes custody to his sister. Just as Jim grapples with his newfound reality, a lawyer contacts him with news of his estranged father's passing. Surprisingly, Jim learns that he has inherited a substantial sum of $200,000 from his father's estate. Fueled by a yearning for freedom and a desire to escape his circumstances, Jim quits his job and embarks on an aimless road trip that stretches on for months. However, as time elapses, Jim's once abundant funds begin to dwindle at an alarming rate. It is during this uncertain period that he picks up a hitchhiker named Jack Pozzi, who reveals himself to be a seasoned gambler. Jack enthralls Jim with a tale of a high-stakes poker game he recently played against two wealthy individuals, Bill Flower and Willie Stone. Intrigued by the possibility of financial gain, Jack proposes an enticing proposition to Jim: if he contributes funds for another poker game against Flower and Stone, they could potentially accumulate significant wealth. Driven by a mix of admiration for Jack's gambling prowess and a burgeoning camaraderie between the two men, Jim finds himself succumbing to the allure of the proposal. He agrees to provide Jack with the necessary funds to enter the poker game with Flower and Stone. Together, Jim and Jack venture to the opulent mansion owned by the affluent duo in Pennsylvania. Bill Flower, once an optometrist, and Willie Stone, a former accountant, amass their considerable fortune through a combination of lottery winnings and shrewd investments. Jim entrusts Jack with $10,000 as his buy-in for the high-stakes poker match. The game begins favorably, with Jack initially gaining the upper hand. However, as the tension builds, the tides turn against Jim and Jack, resulting in a substantial debt of $10,000 owed to Stone and Flower by the end of the game. Intrigue and uncertainty surround Jim Nashe as his journey takes an unexpected turn, leaving readers eager to uncover the subsequent twists and turns that lie ahead in this enthralling narrative. To repay their mounting debt, Jim and Jack are roped into laborious construction work, tasked with building a stonewall on Stone and Flower's expansive estate, a long-held plan of the affluent duo. Under the watchful eye of Calvin Merks, the estate's handyman, Jim and Jack begin their grueling task the following day. Physical exhaustion weighs heavily on their weary bodies as they toil away, taking solace in the trailer that serves as their temporary shelter during breaks and at day's end. Merks, under strict orders to prevent any escape attempts, keeps a constant vigilance over the two men. As frustrations escalate, Jack grows increasingly disgruntled with their circumstances, eventually succumbing to a fit of rage that culminates in a violent confrontation with Merks, landing a solid punch on the supervisor's face. The following day, Merks reappears at the work site, donning a gun holstered on his hip, an unsettling presence that intensifies the already tense atmosphere. After what feels like an eternity of labor, the day of reckoning finally dawns, with Jim and Jack believing they have paid off their debt through their toil. Stone and Flower seemingly concur, granting them permission to revel in a celebratory gathering within the confines of their trailer. However, their hopes are swiftly dashed when Stone and Flower reveal that additional debts remain unpaid, for food and the cost of the party itself. Pushed to his limit, Jack resolves to escape at all costs, prompting Jim to assist him in digging a hole beneath the perimeter fence, facilitating his desperate bid for freedom. Remaining behind, Jim resolves to work until his debts, plus an extra week's labor to cover travel expenses, are fully settled. The following morning, Jim is jolted awake by the sight of Jack outside the trailer, battered and bloodied. As Merks arrives, ostensibly to transport Jack to the hospital in his truck, Jim's suspicions take hold. Doubting the veracity of Merks' claim, Jim fears that his friend's life is in immediate danger. Convinced that Merks intends to do harm rather than provide medical aid, Jim crafts a plan in which he will continue laboring. Driven by the dual purpose of paying off his debts and unearthing the truth behind Jack's injuries. On Jim's final day of labor, Merks unexpectedly offers to treat him to drinks in town, commemorating the fulfillment of his debt. Succumbing to the celebratory atmosphere, Jim indulges in the libations, only to find himself entrusted with the responsibility of driving Merck's truck back to Stone and Flowers' estate. As he takes the wheel, Jim's focus wavers, catching sight of an impending collision with another vehicle. Sensing the inevitability of a head-on crash, Jim's reflexes deviate from the expected evasive maneuvers or braking. Instead, an instinctual surge compels him to accelerate vehemently. I hope you enjoyed this video, leave a like if you did, and be sure to subscribe. Thank you.